Today I'm a very fortunate person. I'm also a very thirsty person. I've been working hard in the workshop all morning. Forgive me, I need this cup of tea. The reasons why I'm so fortunate. Something stuck in my teeth. Is my friend Nicholas, LVI Bushcraft and Survival, has sent me a package. I know what's in it. It's the first, I believe, in the UK. So I'm extremely honoured to receive this as a gift from Nicholas. If a little overwhelmed actually, because I know what it is and I know the effort that he's put into its design. This is not going to be a review, that will come later when I've had a chance to use it, but this is just going to be an unboxing and a show and tell video. Right, I don't want to show anyone's addresses. What's the best way in? Certainly well packaged. Down there. Okey-doke, I can see a letter. That's a wonderful picture. That's a wonderful picture. I'll show you that in a minute. I need a cup of tea, I really do. More wrapping. Oh, lovely. Organic Robies blend. Nicholas has sent me some different teas and coffees to try. Thanks, Nicholas. Now we're on to the meat of the unboxing, almost. Some webbing. We're getting there. I've got a letter here. Right, I'll tell you what it is before I show it to you. In this box is the first Bushcraft of Cookery 7 in the country. It's manufactured by an American company called Topps Knives. I think they're American. And he says that the knife is the result of more than 30 years of outdoor experience. And he goes on to say a British soldier that gave him one as a gift and it introduced him to the cookery style of knife. Though the Nepalese cookery was a great chopping knife, it lacked a lot in other areas for overall functionality. After using many other traditional knives designed for wilderness use, I designed over 20 years ago and finally drafted it to paper in around 2005. Having a loose relationship with Topps Knives, the owner of the company asked Nicholas to send copies over and the rest is history. The knife is designed for both bushcraft and survival use. It's my personal feeling, Nicholas says, that a knife must be large enough to replace a hand hatchet if it is to qualify for survival use, as it will be the only tool a person may have in that situation. So this is a survival tool to help build a shelter, yet it is suitable for smaller tasks. You will hopefully find the factory convex edge sufficient for your use. If not, I suggest massaging the edge in the manner I have done with my own knife. And he's on Nicholas's YouTube channel. He shows how he sharpens his cookery. And you can get it really shaving sharp. I just wanted to extend my thanks for the great camping videos you have presented. Well, I've spent most of my life outdoors at this point. I am living in a city with only weekends to escape to the woods and mountains I live. Your videos have provided me much enjoyment and are greatly appreciated. Thank you, Nicholas. I'm glad you appreciate them, and others tell me that they do as well. Your camping videos are what lead me to your own personal knives. I am not a knife maker, I am only a user and now a designer. If I had a proper workshop, I might make a go of it, but that isn't to be at the present moment in time. Your skill at making your current knives has arrived at master level, in my opinion. Thanks very much. It's been, I served a 3-year apprenticeship now, I think. And I'm quite happy at the level I'm working at. Consistently producing the quality of handmade knives you are is admirable and the mark of a master craftsman. I also have the same perfectionist attitude towards things I design and make myself, so this is something I greatly respect. It's a shame we are not closer. It would be nice to get together or to go off on a several day wilderness trek. Oh, you bet. I would really like to see more of the world. And then he goes on to mention Ken. For some fun. I know Ken Cran feels the same way. He has dirt under his fingernails like we do. People of the earth, that's what we are. Well, next year I'm going to try my hardest to get my passport. My passport's expired, I've got to get a new passport. Save up some money, and who knows, I might go to that meet that Ken went to just recently. That would be an ambition of mine to fulfil. Some land to teach you. My knife is a gift to you, as I extend my hand in friendship across the ocean. Combined with your jackdaw and now the wisp, I believe you have any eventuality covered. All the best from the United States. Your friend, Nicholas. Thank you very much, Nicholas. Now for the moment, the first one in the UK. I believe. Got my little dog down here. Comes with a certificate. Tops knives. This certificate will verify that this knife is made by Tactical Ops USA. 101% handcrafted in the USA. Bit of information on the back on how to maintain it. Another letter here. Tops Knives Bushcraft or Cookery 7, designed by Nicholas. It's all there. You can do a pause the screen if you want to read. It's all there. Now, put that over there, safekeeping. Now for the knife itself. There's a pouch on the front of the sheath, and something in it. Alright, okay. Top knives. So some sort of just a little fastener. I don't know what that is. A whistle, a safety whistle, survival whistle. So that's That's a nice touch, that could save your life. There are two Velcro straps. My dog, not having my tea. She wants my tea. You want my tea, don't you? And here's the knife itself. It comes with a working sharpness of edge. And it's a... Nice recurve, nice heft, and the balance point is quite forward. Right about there, I'd say. It's a very ergonomic shaped handle, and even if you wanted to do light work, like feather sticking, you could, or chest lever, you could use it for that. Because of the forward balance, a good chopper. I'm just casting my knife maker's eye over it. There's a sharpening choil there. A good guard. There's a thumb ramp reference area. Do you want my cup of tea? Nice even grains on it. They've actually powder coated it. I think it's got a powder coat. They powder coated the bevel and then put a convex terminal bevel on. Oh, my dog's pinched my tea. Oh no. I've only got to just turn my back. What do you think you're doing, Elsa? You pinched my tea? You naughty girl. Oh, the things we do. The handle's, I think, some kind of micarta. With very little profile. There's a little bit of profiling gone in there. The pins which hold the micarta on are slightly proud of the surface of the micarta. But I don't think that'll cause any problems when you're holding it and using the knife. I don't feel as though they dig in at all. And on either side, there's a divot on that side, and a divot on that side for using the bow drill. Obviously that's the one I would use, because it would mean the blade would be facing away from me. If I was using the bow drill like that. So this is not a review, it's just a first show and tell of the knife. It's something I will be carrying with me frequently. Oh, there are liners as well. A lanyard hole. And finished to a good standard. Quite a grippy material, the handle. good point on the end. So I can't fault it, Nicholas. It's a beautiful thing. And an exceptional gift. Thank you very much. As I say, I'll be using it, and you'll see me after I've used it for a while and got the feel of it. I'll give you some feedback and do a proper review of it. So that's the Bushcrafter Cookery 7, designed by Nicholas and made by Topps Knives. So that's Nicholas LVI Bushcraft and Survival. That's what you call a tool. Right, that's it from me. I'm back to work. See you all in the next one. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to check out Nicholas's channel, LVI Bushcraft and Survival.